if the media does not report the actual problem to the public, how you expect me to change Malaysian football? How do you expect FAM to change?
Pemilik kelab Johor Darul Takzim JDT, Tunku Ismail Sultan Ibrahim, mahu mereka tahu beliau bukan mahu menjadi wira, sebaliknya hanya ikhlas mahu membantu bola sepak Malaysia dan pasukan kebangsaan. Beliau hanya mahu membantu struktur bola sepak negara agar lebih profesional selain ingin melihat peningkatan.
I don't think they want me as the president because if I'm the president, I'm going to dig everything up. Ini semua drama lah. FAM should just focus on, obviously you have FMLP running the league. They may have to make sure that the league, the competition all runs smoothly without giving any burden to the team participating. Satu. Nombor dua, they have to also focus on the national team punya performance. To me, kalau nak betul, the NFDP budget should go to FAM. FAM allocatekan anak seorang satu kepada all the participating team. You make sure you have your youth development. Kalau tidak, you're not allowed to participate. That's how it should be. That's how it's run in Thailand. That's how it's run in Philippines. Now Indonesia doing a very good job. But kita di sini tak ada. We have NFDP. Jadi semua tidur. Jadi apa je go wrong, we blame FAM. Ni FAM lah salah gini. Bukan dia salah. All of us. Malaysian have to change our mentality. Cara kita berfikir. I give you example. Draw pun awak puji. Dan selesa. Bagus. Persembahan yang baik. Walaupun apa pun, kalah tetap kalah. But you celebrate losing just menunjukkan mentaliti orang kita macam mana. Kita cepat sangat selesa. No. You have to improve. Bila saya bersuara ni, saya memberi nasihat dan pandangan. Bukan untuk mencari salah siapa-siapa. Saya lebih suka start kereta saya atau get into my plane, fly to FAM, fly to KL, pergi FAM, duduk dalam office, dan cakap dekat diorang directly. I want to do that more than talking through media and all that. I want to get more involved. Without being in FAM, I can get more involved. I'm not being rude, I'm not trying to challenge anybody, I'm just giving my betul-betul honest opinion. The problem with me, saya ni tak reti diplomatic, saya ni very direct. But direct for a good cause. It's not to put orang down, it's only memberi cadangan dan pandangan yang ikhlas. What can we do to improve? Because all I want is just to work together. This is not a one man show. We all have to work together lah, bersama-sama lah. Tapi it's very frustrating jikalau macam dah nampak apa masalah tersebut dan kita tak ada buat apa-apa benda yang betul berkenaan on how to fix it. I have a formula. If they follow formula, you will see changes. Yang pertama, let's solve on hak penyiaran kepada pasukan-pasukan lain. I want that money back. I want to see Penang get their money. I want to see Terengganu get their money. I want to see T-Team get their money. I want to see all everybody get money. Selepas tu, semua orang mesti ada program makan umbi sendiri. Second. The third one should be tak ada pasukan-pasukan lain mana boleh lambat bayar gaji lagi. Bayar gaji selepas berapa bulan dia tak boleh bayar gaji, mesti terima hukuman yang patut. There's no special treatment. And last but not least, I don't want the referee to be under FAM. Referee should have an independent body. If we do that, we'll be okay. Itu je saya minta. Bukan saya minta gunung pun. I think one of my initiatives that I'm going to launch, I don't know, maybe a suggestion, that we have to stop using government's money for bola sepak. Private sponsorship. You get this, like mine, not even 1 cent come from Johor State Government. Because the government's money is people's money. To invest in sport for your own political mileage is wrong. You know the amount of money you spend? Other teams, my competitors spend about 30 to 40 million. You cannot every time duit habis, minta Perdana Menteri. Every time duit habis, you go to Kerajaan Persekutuan. That is wrong. So football, if you have, let's say 10 million, what you can get from your sponsorship, then spend within your means. But if you can get 10 million and spend 20, obviously you're going to be broke at the end of the season. And no clubs have long-term plan. Name me one club that have 10 years plan. None. Everybody plan on a yearly basis. Kenapa hanya in Malaysia that players report up to 2 to 3 weeks? Why everywhere else in the world, serious competition, 7 hari. Normal friendly, which is not important, 4 hari. But here, 2 to 3 weeks. Because someone wants to make money from the hotel to claim. But then, I am angry and upset because no one speak out about this. Semua orang diam. We, if the media does not report the actual problem to the public, how you expect me to change Malaysian football? How do you expect FAM to change? You have to put pressure by telling people the truth. The problem is every time you want to tell people the truth, there's a lot of blockage. Semua orang diam, tak nak cakap. So, when you do not address the matter, we do not recognize the problem, how do you end up implementing change? You cannot change because you never report what is the actual problem of Malaysian football. The biggest problem in Malaysian football is corruption. That is the biggest problem. If you can clean up the mess, even though you cannot clean up 100, you can clean up 50 pun, you will see changes in Malaysian football. In terms of how the league is run, how professional the other team is going to be, and the national team. Okay, if anyone wants to repeat after me, I said, what killed Malaysian football? Corruption, favoritism, in denial. Bermakna, korupsi, pilih kasih, tak boleh terima kenyataan. If I am selfish, I just keep quiet. Why? My competitors is going to get weaker every year. Football is not going to get anywhere. And I will be the most successful, dominant force in the whole country. But I'm not selfish, you see. That's why it's called a competition. Because I'm a gentleman. We compete. But I want to see healthy competition. For healthy competition, things need to be done in the right way. I don't know if the new elected president is going to agree that I am going to play a part in terms of the management of the national team. I think I will be interested. I want to find a proper coach, a proper system, a good fitness program, really high intensity training, things, the change the structure, change of how things are, to me, not done in the correct way today. Because today all we see is AFF Cup. Hey, dream bigger lah. Go bigger. Asian qualification, Olympic, go bigger. If we don't get there, doesn't matter, we keep on trying. But if you're going to see only AFF as your target, then susah lah. There's no difference between me and the old president before. Conflict of interest. I have a team. I'm JDT own, I own JDT. If I go to FAM, if they saw JDT win the league, what will people say? If referee give penalty to JDT, what will people say? So, saya tak nak, that's why saya tak nak ambil FAM. Because there's a lot more. To me, I don't want to take over FAM. But I want to be there as a voice that can share my pendapat, probably suggest FAM untuk keluarkan a new punya undang-undang rules in terms of competition. Mungkin saya tak jadi penasihat, mungkin saya jadi penaung diri aja. Kalau dia nak saya lah, kalau tak nak tak payah. I'm not asking for it. But if you want me there, I can be there. Because saya, when it comes to bola sepak tanah yang pasukan kebangsaan ni, I have unfinished business. I don't think they want me as the president. Because if I'm the president, I'm going to dig everything up. Ni semua drama lah. Yeah, jago kampung lah. In-house. Rakyat will be happy menang Piala Malaysia. But sebagai someone who run, siapa yang nak run a professional, a successful club, di manakah Piala Malaysia boleh bawa saya? Yalah, orang Malaysia marahlah bila saya cakap Piala Malaysia ni tak mustahak. Wah Allah, macam mana dia boleh cakap macam ni? The oldest cup in the country. Yes, it is the oldest cup in the country. But for someone who runs a company, who runs a sporting industry, which is a football club, tell me where can it get me to? Dan tak ada orang boleh jawab dengan saya. Dan jangan argue lah. if you have the league FA Cup and then towards the end you have the Malaysia Cup, okay, we can compete for it. But you put my league cup, 3 days later I have to play Malaysia Cup. I have to pick one. Which one is more important? League is more important to me. Because league I can go for AFC. Malaysia Cup memanglah prestige. Piala tertua dalam negara. But it doesn't get me anywhere. Macam mana? The Malaysia Cup is the one that screw up all our timetable. Every year. That's why every time you have the national team playing, the players are gone. We are playing more game than any country in the world. Because of that. Unnecessary. Because right now I see JDT dah telah somehow membawa seri that competition, that determination, people want to beat us. The competition became healthy without people realizing it. It's a good thing, it's not a bad thing. Lagi team lain nak jadi lagi kuat, it's a good thing. Indirectly, when it's more competitive, you are raising the standard of the national players, playing good football against good players. It's good for us. Selagi diorang tak nak berubah, it's going to be hard forever.
If they don't change, do you see Malaysian football ever getting out of the abyss that it's in?
No. We have to change. All of us. Kalau tidak, we're not going to get anywhere. It's going to get worse and worse and worse.